Good morning and welcome to the second day of the working group meeting of Izmir. Now we are going to start with the round table, and I'm quite sure that you enjoyed the first day with the lectures and all the activities organized by Gunay and our team. Today it is important to look for some major issues that are essential to complete and to guarantee the future of our cost action. Here you see three main points in my overview: the status of the mutual cost action, final action dissemination, and how to continue with the mutual activities. I will explain with other slides each of them and with some final considerations at the end of my talk. We start with the Mutalik status. Here we have some interesting numbers that maybe some of you already know. We have involved the 33 pan-European countries. We have 58 MC members, 40 MC substitute, two COST International partner countries. Globally, we arrive up to about 900 contacts that include the members, substitutes, COST International partners, but also all participants that have been involved as speakers, as trainees, as simple participants to our meetings or networking tools. The first section of this slide is related to meetings, training school, and working group meetings. As you see, we have perfectly respected the three events per year for each category, and we arrive now in the last row. You see Izmir, March 2020. With the conclusion of the wall activities. So we are plenty on time and able to complete this procedure. What about the second part of the Notework tools, the short-term scientific missions? We have enrolled 45 mobility programs. Here you see a first list, a second list. Only two of them are not completed, and I believe that those numbers are quite important to understand the impact of our cost action, especially in young investigators. What about the ITC grants? Also, in this case, we have some already developed and paid grants, only eight. That is a good number considering that it started not at the beginning of our cost action, but during the 4 years. And finally, I want to stress your attention on our not working tool, the Chemoteca. This tool was launched officially in Vienna and then again in Siena during the first and the second training school. It's been discussed several times during annual and working group meetings. And at the beginning, it suffered of a limited number of compounds included, because still there is a sort of limitation in, or I mean, difficulty for some colleagues to share eventually the information, or eventually also for technical reasons. We decided to push with a consistent number of new entries just in the last weeks. Actually, now the number of our Chemoteca entries is about 65,000 compounds. So my invitation is, please consider to use it. Also now, Because we have still in progress the research activities with the aim to carry out multi-target drug discovery programs. Okay, now we talk about the funnel action dissemination. This additional networking tool was approved by us in October 2019 and then also by the Coast Association. We put as expected release next April 21st. And the structure of the approved FAD is reported in the following points. So we will start with the history and purposes of Mutualid Cost Action, the creation of our network, the 4-year journey with a chronological scenario in which we will talk about each year activity in terms of meetings, training school, STSM, and so on. Then there is a section related to scientific publications that we have to look very carefully, and successful cooperative applications. In other words, calls that were successfully applied and obtained in terms of funding resources for our purposes. An interview of selected Mutualid participants is also previewed, as well as a special memorial section related to our colleague Maurizio Botta. And then we will conclude with the future perspective of the Mutualid network. We have, in order to be able to get a perfect FAD, we need a strong collaboration from all Mutualid participants. So what I ask you, first of all, is to check for all publications carried out with explicit acknowledgement of the Mutualid Cost Action. Please look if they are correctly cited in our webpage. This is the first issue to consider. Then again, what about the STSM activities? Are those all reported correctly into our webpage? If not, we should integrate the information in order to complete the webpage and also to have enough information for the FAD. For the ITC grant, it is the same recommendation. This is something that I will do personally because I've cared about the ITC grants. And the last part, the fourth point, is funding resources related to the activity of the Cost Action. This should be communicated directly to me in order to complete the collection. My request is close, because otherwise we have no time to process all the information. So please check the 4 points that I have just explained here and let me know something within 1 week, so within next Friday 13. We have also created a sort of promo FAD that is a beta test version, let's say, to give you an idea of the multimedia product we are currently preparing. You will see it and you can ask directly to Antonio Lupia, but also we will put it in a YouTube channel that we have already activated for the video tutorial of the Chemoteca. Any feedback to this, let's say, promo version could be addressed to Antonio, but we have also in program to create, let's say, 2 versions. What you will see in few minutes is the short version, that is about 3 minutes, and then we'll have also a larger version that should be about 20 minutes and will cover all issues of the approved proposals in the. Another important issue that I want to discuss with you is how to continue the Mutualid activities. As you know, we have submitted the Mutualegre Plus proposal to the Cost Innovation Grant. We have unfortunately no good feedback in the pre-selection, so the effort spent might be used in other directions. We have probably one option to claim for a redress, but likely we have to think about other initiatives. So one option is relatively close in terms of deadline, represented by the RISE, Research Innovation Staff Exchange. The deadline will close at the end of April on 28, and the code of this call is MSCA RISE 2020. So I invite you to look and to let me know something about your interest to be eventually involved in this. The other option that also we can propose is a new cost action. Also in this case, the deadline is relatively close, is on 29 of April, and here you see which is the expected evaluation process. So if successful in after the summer, we should start with a new cost action that might be well designed as well as the RISE in order to be effective. So please think about these opportunities and maybe others that you can propose me and let me know. So let's go straight to the conclusion. Mutualegre Cost Action is a successful cooperation project that gave to hundreds of scientists the opportunity to collaborate and to create consistent research activities. We need to keep in touch in order to avoid that a virus can affect negatively our network, and likely we need to use as much as possible internet-based tools in order to keep together. And this video and the other that I have prepared for you is just examples of them. We also need to complete the activities for the FAD multimedia project. A strong collaboration is required for all marketing opportunity. I propose to create a webinar that could be fixed on April 21st in the occasion of the FAD release. This could be our next appointment. But also we have many interesting calls to take into account in order to have a future together. So please let me know as about your intentions. I want to conclude with some wishes related to our logo, to our working groups, but also with the aim that a virus that now is the monster that is affecting our life could be destroyed by us, maybe in an activity that we can carry out all together. So, thank you so much for your attention. I think we can start with the roundtable. I will do my best to interact by Skype, and I'm sure that good ideas will be obtained at the end of this meeting. And thank you again for be there in any kind of way, virtually or physically. Bye. See you later.